Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I like to thank all my subscribers all over the world for subscribing me and making my YouTube channel Marine Tech Hub to the highest level. So I would like to tell a little bit more about my channel. I have been running this channel for the last 5 years. Last 4 years the channel was free. Now I have come to a level where I got the membership. So membership level 1, 2, 3, the level membership 5, which is rupees 3999. In this channel where I am be giving you all the videos for 1 year, plus I'll be helping you for all the troubleshooting at real time from anywhere. So lot of superintendents, chief engineers and all engineers are calling me for troubleshooting. I am very happy. It was my dream that I should have a channel like this where I'll be able to help people and shipping companies to save time and money. So you can always choose whichever membership you want, but level 5 I'll give you all the help, and online training I'm giving you online training for rupees 1499. Plus if you want to subscribe, you can pay me. The bank details are here. If you want to pay through bank, and you can, if you want to pay through Paytm, you can scan the QR code. So I'll very much thankful to all the subscribers again, and have a nice day. Thank you. Today I'll explain you about the deck air compressor screw type, make TMC, and what went wrong. If you see this diagram, simple diagram of the deck air compressor screw type, you can see this is the screw type compressor here. This is the air filter. We got the pulley, we got the motor here. This is the oil separator. This is the oil cooler, air cooler here. I will explain briefly the function of it. We are looking into the orifice here. This is the oil separator. The oil need to come back through the orifice to the bearing. If this is clogged, then the bearing get damaged. This is what happened in our case. One reason for the compressor bearing got damaged is the orifice was clogged. For orifice to get clogged, the oil had water. I'll explain you why water came into the system. I will explain you briefly the line diagram here. So if you see this is the oil cooler. You can see the oil is coming from this chamber. You can see it run this here. It's going here, then coming out, going here. You can see this. And we have got a water line, inlet and outlet. You can see the water coming in from here and going through this and out here. So water is again used to maintain the temperature of the air and the oil, so that oil is cooled and air is also cooled. So you can see the water, and these are the filters here. You can see the filters here, and these are safety valves. So main concern here is make sure that the temperature of the compressor running should be above 80 or 90 degrees. Why? Because of the humidity in the air, there is always possibility that water can come into the oil. So you have to make sure your sump oil is not contaminated by water. I will tell you that. So this is the cover we opened, and I'm talking about this orifice here, return line. This is the outlet hole for the lube oil. This is the cover where I opened it. This is a non-return valve. So this orifice was clogged. So if you want to see the damaged bearing, this is the damaged bearing. So the whole bearing was damaged, and the company had told us to replace the whole compressor. So we spent around $10,000 on this. So make sure that such kind of problem doesn't occur in your vessel. I am talking about this graph here, relative humidity 80%, relative humidity 100%. So if the humidity is 80%, then what you have to do is inlet temperature of the air. This temperature, inlet temperature, mostly the temperature of the air will be around 30 or 35 in this range. So, and pressure is around 10 bar. If you are assuming, you go this blue line. If temperature is around air temperature 30 degrees, you come up here, then come this side. So it's 80 degree. The compressor should be running at temperature of 80 degrees. Use the infrared temperature gun to measure the temperature of the compressor. This should be above this line. So if the temperature is below, then there is possibility the condensation taking place. So you have to change the oil regularly if you are not maintaining the temperature. The important thing to note is you need to run the compressor at least twice a week. If you are not using a TMC compressor, run it at full load for at least half an hour. So when you run like this, there is always possibility that water condensation will not take place. If you are not running it, there is always possibility that condensation will take place and you have to spend lot of money on maintenance of the deck air compressor. So very important point. So please remember, for safe running and save money and time for the company. Thank you.